So now I'm going to talk about playing full bow strokes from the heel of the bow to the point and back again. Full bow strokes combine the lower half swinging shoulder movement and the upper half opening and closing of the elbow movement. We've talked about these movements separately in previous videos, and now we're going to combine them to play a full bow stroke from the heel to the point and back again. So first of all, get your violin comfortable, form your bow hold, place your bow on the A string at the balance point. Now just check that your fingers are relaxed. Try lifting your fingers off the bow one by one, they should all lift off very easily. And check that your thumb is nice and relaxed, this muscle should be soft. Now make sure that your elbow is in line with your bowing hand. We don't want the elbow to be too high or too low. They should just be level with each other. And now we'll just start making some bow strokes between the balance point and the heel. Now if you remember, we do this by swinging the shoulder like this. And that movement comes from the shoulder. It's a swinging movement of the shoulder with my relaxed wrist and fingers following that movement. Now gradually, I'm going to make my down bow strokes longer so that I work my way up towards the middle of the bow, like this. And can you see that as I approach the middle of the bow, I'm beginning to open out my arm from the elbow? And I need to do this in order to keep the bow straight. If I don't do this, this is the kind of thing that will happen. So you'll start sliding down the string and you'll get a sort of skating sound from the bow. So make sure you begin to open out your arm from the elbow as you approach the middle of the bow. Now I'm going to do a few bow strokes and then I'm going to stop at the square position and then talk about the bow movement from the square position to the point. So starting at the heel in the lower half with short bow strokes between the balance point and the heel. Now gradually making them longer. Now I've got to about the square position. The square position, if you remember, is when the bow, the forearm and the upper arm roughly form three sides of a square. And when you get to this point, when you get to this position, all you need to do to get to the point of the bow is just open out the elbow, like that. So the upper arm doesn't need to move anymore, you're just opening out the elbow. So I'll just show you those movements altogether. I'll stop at the square position and then carry on so you can see how these movements all work together. So start with short bow strokes. Make them longer. Now get to the square position. And then carry on up to the point and back. See that when I reach that square position, all I need to do is just open my elbow to get to the point. Sometimes people don't open their elbow enough, and this is the kind of thing that happens. So people can sometimes swing their elbow back behind them to reach the point, and what happens then is that the bow will again slide down the string. So remember to really open up the elbow as you reach the point. So I'm going to show you those bow stroke movements now without stopping in the middle. And can you see that as I move down the bow, my wrist moves away from me very gradually, and as I move up the bow, my wrist moves towards me. Now this movement is essential and is a passive movement. The wrist is following the bowing arm, so the movement comes from either the shoulder or the elbow, depending on which part of the bow you're playing in, and the wrist follows. And you can do that by keeping your bowing hand nice and relaxed and your fingers nice and flexible. So I'll just show you again. See how my wrist is just following that movement, and that's what helps keep the bow straight. So finally, we'll just talk about changing bow direction. Try and do this as smoothly as possible. So don't speed the bow up or flick your wrist in a sudden movement to change bow. And don't press down with your hand. What we want to do is just to imagine we're just bouncing off something and then carrying on in the opposite direction. So it's almost like the movement is undisturbed, it just carries on going, but in the other direction. So I'll just show you that. So imagine you're just bouncing off a bouncy wall when you reach the extremes of the bow. So bounce. So work on making those bow changes really smooth, because when we come to play pieces, that will help you get a lovely smooth melodic line in the music that you play. So that was full bow strokes from the heel to the point and back again.